Whoa. You know, a lot of Libras like to say that they don't get jealous. But I beg to differ, all right? I beg to differ, that Libras don't get jealous. Libras, you totally get jealous. And here's one scenario I'm going to tell you where you get jealous. You tend to get jealous. One way to piss a Libra off, male or female, all right, is to flirt with someone that they have their eye on. Flirting with the object of a Libra male or a Libra female's eye or eyes, flirting with the object of a Libra male or Libra female's eyes is a big no-no, all right? Especially if you are a friend, if you are a friend, or if a Libra considers you a friend. That's betrayal, okay? Don't do it. Don't do it unless you want to see the scales tip over. Ooh, and you know, a mad Libra is not a pretty Libra. And we all know that Libras love to be pretty at all times. Libras love to be beautiful and gorgeous at all times, all right? One way to piss a Libra off. By the way, Libras are like really good at taking mental notes, especially mental notes of you know, the object of their desire or their eyes. So a Libra, you know, when having a conversation with the object of their eyes or their desire, they're gonna take mental notes of, you know, the person's reactions, the person's body language, you know, the person's teeth and how well their teeth are taken care of, you know, the person's skin and you know, oh, he or she has, you know, a couple bumps here and there, you know, we're gonna figure out a way to clean that up, you know, like Libras love to make other people beautiful, especially the object of their, you know, their desire. Libras are really good at seeing the beauty in people who other people sometimes don't see as beautiful. You know, Libras are like, what do you see? You know, or like, not Libras themselves, but other people will be like, Libra, what do you see in that person? Like, you know, their skin is horrible. You know, they have braces. Like, you know, but Libras, because they're so able to see both sides of a situation at all times and they're so diplomatic and, you know, all that great stuff, Libras will be like, well, you know, they have braces, you know, that means they're, you know, getting their teeth, you know, perfected. So when those braces come off, they'll probably have a beautiful smile. And as for their skin, we can clean that up. We can figure out a way to clean that right on up. So Libras just love beautiful people, especially beautiful people who are beautiful inside and out. And, you know, I kind of don't remember where I was going with that. But there are like three planets in retrograde right now, and they're all like prominent placements in my chart. So, by the way, I'm a Libra moon, all right? So it's nice to meet you. I'm Lamar Townsend. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Follow me on Instagram at Lamar Townsend. Like me on Facebook, facebook.com/LamarTownsendOfficial. Also, check out my website, lamartownsendtarot.com. You can purchase your own personal, private, confidential tarot reading from me. I am also, aside from being an astrologer and a zodiac enthusiast, I am also a psychic, psychic, intuitive, clairvoyant, clairaudient. I need to get better at saying this. Tarot reader. I'm also an artist and a musician and an entrepreneur. I mean, the list goes on. But you can contact me at lamartownsendtarot.com for your own personal, private, confidential tarot reading. My readings are not free. I do video readings, much where I would send you a video like this, except I'd be reading tarot. You send me a list of questions, or you would just be like, I need a general reading on my life. here's what I'm going through right now. Tell me about myself or whatever. Like, you know, give me insight or clarity on this situation or my life, you know. And I'll do a tarot reading and, you know, I'll send you a lovely inspirational video, okay? So, yeah. Please contact me at lamartownsendtarot.com or you can contact me at lamar.townsend@gmail.com for your own personal, private, confidential tarot reading. Also, you can check out my website for personal reading testimonials from people who have gotten readings from me. And clients who have, like, come back, you know, multiple times, by the way. I love those clients because we've built a, you know, relationship with one another, so... You know, I love it. So anyways, also follow me on Google Plus. Check out my SoundCloud and my Bandcamp. So yeah, there are like so many planets going retrograde right now. And if you don't know what a retrograde is, it's when a planet goes... When a planet is going direct, that means, you know, the planet is moving forward, you know. Things are going as normal. When a planet goes retrograde, that means the planet moves backwards. So, obviously, you know, the planets in the sky, we are uber affected by, you know, things like that. When, you know, a planet goes retrograde or goes direct, you know. Especially according to our zodiac and astrology. So, I'm a Capricorn sun. Saturn is currently retrograde. Capricorn is ruled by Saturn. I'm also a Virgo rising. Mercury is currently retrograde. Mercury is the ruler of Virgo and Gemini. Also, Saturn rules Aquarius as well. Aquarius and Capricorn. I am also a Libra moon. Libra is ruled by Venus. Venus is, I think, I don't know if Venus is actually still retrograde right now. But it was for a long while. So I'm just pooped and I'm ready for everything to go direct, alright? So excuse me if I'm like uber spacey and, you know, my thoughts aren't exactly clear in this, you know, or exactly like well or organized as they are usually. By the way, I'm a Mercury, my Mercury is in Sagittarius, my Mars is in Sagittarius. So sometimes I'm just jumbled in general, and I think a lot of you know that already, so I'm not really too worried about it. You know, the most important stuff will come out, as it should. With all that being said, one of the ways to piss a Libra off is to flirt with someone they have their eye on, okay? A Libra, you know, when they are interacting with the object of their eye, they are... definitely taking in everything about the object of their eye, how the person is reacting to the Libra themselves, how the person's body language and, you know, certain the person's aesthetic beauty, you know, aesthetic, is the person aesthetically pleasing to the Libra, like, you know, like a Libra's gonna especially pay attention to this stuff when they're up close to you, like, you know, when the Libra's like up close to you, like, in personal, you know, like, in conversation, you know, like, the Libra's definitely going to be assessing, you know. So, all the while, the Libra's also going to be assessing when you are interacting with other people, okay? They're going to be watching your body language. They want to know what their place in your life. And one of the ways they figure that out is by assessing your body language and, you know, assessing the way you look at other people and interact with other people. And they're going to compare that to how you interact with them. Okay? So if a Libra finds you, you know, the object of their eye flirting with someone else, or if they, you know, especially if it's a Libra's arch nemesis enemy, oh no. That will really tip the Libra off the scales, okay? But I digress. Coming back down to earth, because... I'm going there, all right? one way to, you know, piss a Libra off is, you know, I guess this is two combined into one. Another way to piss a Libra off is to betray them. Especially, you know, a betrayal from someone that they trust. Libras can sometimes have trouble trusting the right people, Because Libras get so wrapped up in beauty and oh, this person's so beautiful, sometimes Libras can be blindsided by beauty, okay? Whatever. And for Libras, not one thing that is beautiful to one Libra is not gonna be beautiful to the next Libra, okay? Sometimes people look at the Libra and can be like, how can you find this person beautiful? Like, it's all up to that Libra, okay? Beauty is in the eye of the beholder, literally, all right? Anyways, Libras don't like to be betrayed, and Libras don't like. Libras don't like to be betrayed, and Libras don't like. Libras are really weird and territorial, all right? They don't like people invading their space. And in a weird way, other people are considered their space. Not just other people, but certain people that the Libras hold dear to them. Okay, so I'm going back to that thing where, like, the Libras can sometimes. By the way, Libra, I'm talking about Libra's sun, moon, rising. Mercury and Mars, maybe, all right, those are kind of, maybe trait, tra you know, placements where these traits might show up, but the placements where these traits are going to show up more, more overtly, more in a way where you can, like, be like, hey, that Libra side of you is coming out is the Libra sun, moon, and rising. Libras can sometimes not trust, or not, I don't want to say not trust the wrong people, but Libras can sometimes trust people too easily, okay, without really discerning, certain people without really discerning and questioning people, people's intentions, So because Libra can sometimes get so wrapped up by beauty and, the object of their desire, Libras can sometimes trust the object of their desire, in a weird way. And the object of their desire can, in a weird way, because the Libra trusts the object of their desire because they're so beautiful and I love them and they're the one. Remember, this sign is ruled by Venus, the planet of love, and passion and romance, okay? So they're always about partnership, and they need to be in a relationship. They hate being single, okay? So any chance a single Libra can get to, find someone to latch onto, whether it be temporarily or, hopefully long term, the Libra will take it. All right, I digress. Sometimes Libras can, un naively trust people, in a weird way. When a Libra trusts people, because a Libra doesn't trust people so easily. Libra can sometimes be delusional in that way and thinking, I don't trust people that easily. Libra. All right. I'm talking about myself, by the way, because I'm a Libra moon, all right? Libra, because you're so delusional sometimes in that way, you let people slide in that don't need to be in all in your space. Anyways, people you trust and that you love become your space because they're now in your space, okay? So when you find, the object of your desire, flirting with someone else, and proving that, to you at least, that, your place in their life isn't as important as you had thought or hoped, that's a betrayal, all right? And you may not even know that person that well, all right? You may only be on the surface level of that person because, well, Libra, you tend to get what you give, so you tend to. You're a very surface level kind of person, okay? Especially with people you don't know that well. With someone you love, with family, oh, you're an open book. You really let people have and let people know You know, let your family members know how you feel. You know, friends, you know, just people that you hold really close to you. You know, you're an open book with those people. But with people you don't really know and trust, you're very surface level. but in a weird way, you can be kind of self-delusional and giving up trust, you know, and kind of the keys to your heart to people you don't really know that well. And you end up getting hurt, Libra. And then you end up getting pissed off. So one way to piss Libra off is to, you know, betray them, betray their trust. If you're a friend of a Libra, you know, and you know, you're a Libra, because Libras are very social, they have so many friends and connections, they can connect people, you know, from all over, you know, the world and all over. You know, different personalities and stuff. You know, Libras tend to get along with all the signs, you know. So, anyways. Say a Libra, you know, has a friend, and they introduce their friend to another friend of theirs. Well, say that these friends, two friends, hit it off and start hanging out without the Libra, who introduced these two to one another in the first place. That's a betrayal to the Libra. That's going to piss the Libra off, okay? And to the two friends, you know, that may seem like, oh, why is the Libra getting so mad? Well, you know, he or she introduced us, we hit it off, we're like really good pals now, you know, they did a good thing. Why are they so upset? Well, the Libra wasn't included. The Libra Libras love to be included. Libras need to be included. So include the Libra, okay? It's not nice to, you know, not include Libras in things, alright? Especially... you know, when it concerns people that they love, you know, and that they trust, you know, it's not being included in those types of things is a betrayal to the Libra. So don't betray the Libra or, you know, you're going to piss the Libra off, all right? Third way to piss the Libra off is to criticize their appearance. All right? Libra is all about beauty and, you know... aesthetic, you know, Libras love to be aesthetically pleasing, aesthetically beautiful. They love to know that they're wanted and desired. So if you criticize the Libra and say, oh, that hair color, you know, girl or boy, you know, that doesn't work for you. Are you dyeing your hair to cover up those gray hairs, you know? Why are you doing that, you know? Weren't last week, didn't you have gray hair up there, you know? That mohawk, why, Libra? What made you want to do that? That haircut, why did you cut all that gorgeous hair off? You need to shave, Libra. You look, you know, this caveman look isn't working for you, you know? Libra, your eyebrows, what's going on with them? Have you been plucking them, you know, lately? All that is really going to upset the Libra. Libra, your makeup, you need to blend more. That tone doesn't work for you. Oh my gosh. Talk about a pissed off Libra. These comments will send Libra off the edge. That shirt, it's so ugly, you know, it's, why are you wearing that shirt? What you don't know is that shirt is so meaningful to Libra. That Libra has actually had that shirt since he or she was, you know, 15. And luckily, it still fits, you know, which says a lot about the Libra, you know? So instead of criticizing the Libra and his or her fashion choices, instead of criticizing the Libra and his or her decision to dye their hair or cut their hair or you know, style their hair in a different way or, you know, do a completely new hairstyle, new hairdo. Why don't you focus on yourself, okay? See, I'm getting upset, all right? Like, I got criticized about my appearance or something. Libras just don't like to be criticized. Libras like to be beautiful at all times. They love compliments, okay? They don't like to be criticized. They don't like to know that, you know, the color that they're wearing isn't working for them. They don't like to know that the haircut they decided to go with is does not suit their face. Or, you know, like Libras, they don't like to hear that, okay? So don't criticize their appearance. Libras are very, actually quite, you know, hard to get pissed off, you know. They're very easygoing people, very diplomatic, you know, people. They actually don't tend to get pissed off very easily, you know. So we've talked about three ways to piss the Libra off. What's another way to piss the Libra off? I know. Take Libra's kindness for weakness. Fourth way to piss a Libra off is to take their kindness for weakness. Libras are people pleasers. Okay? We are. You know, we tend to be people pleasers sometimes. We want to please people, you know, and it's because we love harmonious atmospheres and we don't like discord. We don't like conflict. We don't like arguments. We don't like, you know, we don't like conflict, okay? We love peace and harmony, and we love, you know, an atmosphere where everyone is happy and everyone's getting what they want, you know, and that's how we want the world to be. We want world peace. We want flowers blooming everywhere, and we want beauty, you know, we want the sky to be, you know, gorgeous every day. Like, that is the ideal world for Libra. We just love beauty, but sometimes, Libra, you know, Libras have to come out of that mode of self-delusion and see life for what it is, and life isn't always what it seems, you know? And this is one of those moments where I'm having a total brain fart. Ugh. Oh. I was saying, Libras and their people-pleasing ways cause people to take their kindness for weakness. I think I went off the deep end, but I made a really good point, actually, that totally ties into this point, or this subject of Libras kind of being taken for granted, and that pisses them off, okay? But it's the Libras' need for peace and harmony and things to be beautiful, and, you know, Libras just don't like discord or conflict. They love peaceful surroundings, and, you know, but sometimes they have to take off the rose-colored glasses, seriously, you know, and see situations for what they are, and see people for what they are, and that's when you have a pissed-off Libra. When a Libra takes off those rose-colored glasses and finally sees, oh, you've been taking advantage of me this whole time, you've been taking advantage of my kindness and my people-pleasing ways, and my need for beauty and security and harmony this whole time, oh, that's a pissed off Libra, alright? Don't do it. Don't take their kindness for weakness, okay? Because eventually those rose-colored glasses are totally going to come off, and things won't be the same, ever. And I'm dead serious about that. As I say that with a smile. So that's four ways to piss off a Libra. Wow, Libras, quite angry people, aren't they? But you would never know that because they're so good at suppressing their anger and repressing their anger and hiding it from you. It only comes out when necessary. Okay, when they've been pushed to the edge, when their skills have been tipped over, you know, a little bit too much. All right. What's another way to piss Libra off? This is kind of fun. I like this. Another way to piss a Libra off is to bully them. To make fun of them and their quirkiness and their quirky habits, you know. The fact that they like to collect dolls, or the fact that they like, you know, to collect makeup, or that they have this weird habit of I don't know, painting, you know, at 4 a.m. in the morning, or that they have this weird habit of loving to smoke Cuban cigars, you know, like, I don't know, Libras are weird like that, like, I have so many weird habits, you know, you know, the fact that Libras take long showers, Libras, you know, can sometimes be lazy, you know, Libras love their beauty rest. Like, Libras put so much emphasis on themselves and propping themselves up for other people, okay, for the happiness and harmony of other people, because they know that they themselves are a vessel for creating that for other people, you know, whether it be just a simple conversation with another person, or whether it be, you know, just being the mediator for people around them, or whether it be them helping around the house, or helping, you know, at their job, you know. You know, maybe the Libra knows exactly what their place is at their job, and the position that they play at their job, and just that Libra being there and playing that position creates harmony and balance for that, you know, that situation, that company, that you know what I'm saying. So when a Libra gets bullied or made fun of, or, you know, people are throwing tomatoes at the Libra, laughing at the Libra, ah, you're such a joke, you know, you like to collect, you know, toys, you like to, you know, I don't know, you like to paint and do artistic things, you know, you like to write poetry, and you like Shakespeare, and all these, you know, when you're, you know, making fun of the Libra, and the Libra's, you know, playing it off and laughing with you, actually, the Libra's, you know, gets kind of pissed off, you know, sometimes. Libras can sometimes be moody, so you get the Libra on the wrong day. Sometimes, you know, the Libra's not going to want to laugh with you, you know, as you're making fun of him or her for their quirkiness. Sometimes the Libra's probably going to go off on you or to put you in your place. Because, you know, that's one way to piss a Libra off, is to make fun of them or bully them. Libras don't like to get bullied because chances are when they were a kid, they got bullied, okay? Libras are very connected to their childhood. 9 times out of 10, they hate going to certain places that kind of resonate with their childhood. So, you know, don't take the Libra back to that childhood place of being bullied or made fun of, because Libras don't like it. And I told you, as they get older, you know, Libra will stand up more and more for him or herself. Alright? So that's, I think we're on 5 now. 5 ways to piss the Libra off. 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6. What's the 6th way to piss the Libra off? Another way to piss the Libra off is to How can I word this? Another way to piss the Libra off is to manipulate them. Because Libras are so easily influenced and so easily, you know, sometimes Libras are so easily able to kind of be puppets for people. Because, you know, sometimes people know just the right heartstrings to pull to get the Libra to do whatever they want. Especially people that are close to the Libra. The Libras hate that. And here's the thing with Libras. Libras are so unusual and complex, you know. But they love harmony. They love harmony. They love harmony. They love happiness. They love to make other people happy, even at the expense sometimes of their own happiness. A Libra will know that you're manipulating them, and a Libra will hate it. But a Libra will let you sometimes manipulate them anyway, in a weird way, because they don't want to disappoint you, because they don't want to make you unhappy, because they don't want to piss you off. They'll allow them their own selves to be pissed off, you know? And I can attest to this in my own life. But eventually, there inevitably always comes a point where the Libra stands up for him or herself. And with my Capricorn moon, or Capricorn sun, and my Mercury and Mars and Sagittarius, okay, I will let you know for sure, alright, when I am done, when I am tired of being manipulated, when I am tired of, you know, being betrayed, when I'm tired of being ridiculed and criticized and being made fun of. Like, I will let you know when I'm pissed off, when I'm tired of you flirting with my my boyfriend in my head, okay? Alright, you're gonna get the pissed off side of me. And I know the Libras, okay, understand. Can I get a Hey ya, okay, from a Libra who understands exactly what I'm saying. Okay, so we've talked about six ways to piss a Libra off, okay? Okay. The last and final way to piss a Libra off, all right? I'm telling you this right now, okay? The last and final way to piss a Libra off is to criticize. Notice I have talked about criticizing a Libra so much in this video. But this is a different type of criticism, all right? This is something that a Libra holds very dear to them, because the Libra's all about beauty and art, all right, and stuff like that. Never ever criticize a Libra's taste in music, a Libra's music collection, a Libra's fashion collection, a Libra's taste in TV shows or any artist, anything that has to do with artistic, a Libra's taste in poetry and books. Just don't do it, all right? What you don't know is that is the heart and soul of a Libra, all right? The music that they listen to, their taste in music, their specific taste in music, okay? Their specific music collection that they have, okay? Their specific art that they have around their house in their room, okay? There's always a rhyme and a reason to a Libra, okay? Their specific poetry that they write, their specific poetry that they read, the books that they read, the movies, the TV shows, the documentaries that they watch. Don't ever call anything that a Libra listens to or watch stupid. Don't do it. Don't ever say that the music a Libra listens to is whack. That is the first and ultimate way to get on the Libra's shit list, okay? Is to criticize their music or any artistic format that they love, okay? Because that is the true heart and soul of a Libra, I'm telling you, all right? If you can't get down to the music a Libra listens to, or if you can't get down to a Libra's, exquisite taste in going to Broadway shows, or, going to, blockbuster movies, going to the movie theater every weekend, or the Libra's expensive taste of wine, or exquisite taste of just a certain movie genre. And it can be a really, really weird, not weird movie genre, but just a weird, really, really foreign or like exclusive movie genre. Like one Libra friend I know I work with loves Mad Max, and I'm like, what is with you and Mad Max? But the kid loves Mad Max, and I can't knock him for it, all right? Like, I'm a Libra Moon, I know I definitely have my weird. I love horror slasher films. Actually, my dream is to star in a slasher film, horror movie. Don't make fun of me for it. Some people make fun of me for it, and I get pissed off. Don't do it, okay? I'm just saying, all right? These are all ways to piss Libra off. Pissed off Libra is not a pretty Libra, and like I said, Libras love to be beautiful and pretty at all times, okay? So don't make the Libra come out of character, okay? Ever. All right? As long as Libra can stay in his or her place of being beautiful and harmonious, the Libra is happy, all right? Don't betray him or her. Don't flirt with his or her boyfriend or girlfriend, whether they are in his or her head or they're actually officially boyfriend or girlfriend. Don't criticize the Libra. Don't make fun of the Libra, bully the Libra, all right? Don't betray the Libra. Don't manipulate the Libra. Don't take advantage of the Libra's kindness, okay? These are all ways to piss the Libra off, and these are all ways to potentially lose the Libra forever. So you make the choice, okay? Thank you for listening and watching. I love you guys so much. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Check out my website, lamartownsendtarot.com. Subscribe, subscribe, subscribe. Press the notification button so you get a notification whenever I upload a new video. Follow me on Instagram at Lamar Townsend. Like me on Facebook, facebook.com/LamarTownsendOfficial. And all right, guys, I'll catch you next time. Libras, I love you. You guys are gorgeous, as always, okay? We have the best sense of fashion and music and creativity and art. And no one can tell us otherwise, okay? We're quirky. We are courageous. We are ourselves, okay? And people either love us or hate us. Either way, we're still going to be fabulous, okay? Thank you guys for listening and watching. Love ya. Bye. Contact me for your own personal reading, okay? See ya.